How did you do?
We missed it. We were talking about Giallo films.
Yeah. Good discussion about Giallo films.
Unfortunately, all of our good discussions about films are killed off.
Yeah. They're all movies.
But we have finished our food.
Yeah.
And it was good food.
It was good food, of course.
Great food.
It was better than
yes, I will be able
to. I pretty much had the site but less, but it seemed to be bad.
Yeah.
Don't know that well. There was a lot of good stuff on that plate yesterday.
Yeah.
Right now, we were talking about Giallo films and what we liked and what we didn't like about Fiat Farrow films. We got into Rob Zombie for a little bit.
Yeah. Nobody should have to talk about Rob Zombie.
No, we don't like Rob Zombie.
No.
Just a hack.
Yeah. Basically.
It's pretty much a thief.
Yeah. Yeah.
But that's the
Rob Zombie films. You know, F-bombs, C-bombs.
Yeah.
Just so necessary.
Yelling and swearing for no reason.
Yeah. And it's just loud and obnoxious.
Yeah.
That's not horrible.
No. So well, we were talking about one that I wanted to see, Giallo-wise, because that one, the Paul Nash, the Dragonfly, the Blue Eyes, the Broken Doll, I've seen that one.
Coming to the Dragonfly.
There's another one that's kind of like, you know, Bullet and the Dragonfly or something like
yeah,
that. I'm going to have to check that one out. That's more like a police drama. Yeah. House of Psychotic Women is a good one. It's a straightforward, weird film.
Yeah.
You know, who's the killer? Who's the killer? Who's the killer? The other weird one, I don't know if that one's considered as Giallo, but the Don't Torture a Duckling is weird.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a
it's like a supernatural religious theme.
Yeah, that's a weird one. It's a fold chain.
That's one of got one of the most uncomfortable scenes, like, where she's getting chained in the cemetery. Plus, it's got the best spinal I've ever seen. Man literally has his face rubbed away by a
I have that on a double disc of City Rage and Bad News.
I need to buy those folks again.
What's your favorite?
Giallo?
Yeah. Giallo is Watch When I Kill.
Watch When I Kill, that's right.
It's a rather nice, low key, but atmospheric film.
Yeah.
What's got the best score?
Mine is Tenebrae.
That's a telegram. Yeah, and then the thing is, it's one of those ones where it's in your face.
Oh yeah, and it doesn't hold back.
Yeah, it doesn't hold back.
But it's not too much.
Though. Yeah, like, it's not like the New York Ripper crazy, but it definitely doesn't hold back.
Yeah.
And the girl gets her hand cut. Like it's right over that white wall.
Oh,
and it's just in your face.
Yeah, in your face.
But just the shots. It pulls out of the house.
Yeah.
It goes up the house or over the house.
Yeah.
Through another window. Down this, like, how did you do that?
That's the crazy thing.
Yeah. I think the score is awesome.
Yeah.
I've always liked that scene, even though I'm not a big fan of the film, but opera.
Oh, yeah.
Where the camera's just spinning down.
Mm-hmm.
Down. Down.
And she gets the pins in her eyes.
That's a weird scene.
Yeah,
the whole thing's a weird scene because it doesn't play out like you think it would.
No,
no. Yeah, there's a lot of different ones, and I mean, Deep Red is the one that everyone says is like the best Giallo, but I think Tenebrae is.
Deep Red's okay.
Deep Red is really good.
It's a good film.
Yeah.
Favorite one.
And there's so many different cut versions of it too.
Yeah, you know.
But it's a long. It's not a cut. It's a long film. That's the film.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
Actually, I didn't know that. I didn't realize this at first, but the lady from Night Train Murders is actually in there. She gets the one through the window in the beginning. She gets strangled in the face.
Like Sylvia Crystal.
Yeah.
Huh? That's like
I can't
Crystal's
remember her name.
Well,
oh, that's Amanda.
Yeah. I don't even care. She was in Midnight Express as well.
Oh, was she?
That's a good film. Not Italian or Giallo, but that's a lovely film.
I don't have that one, I have Horror Express.
Yeah.
Because really, you don't score with George Everybody. I'll have to check that one out. I'll have to check out Midnight Express.
Yeah,
but I love Night Train Murders. Night Train Murders to me is probably the best revenge film, like a weird.
Yeah.
Because the thing is though, it does it does come after Last Outward Left. It was made after that, so you know it's kind of like
a hit spot. But the way it plays out, it's like...
It's the, yeah.
But I think the ending to Night Train Murders is much more satisfying.
It is. Yeah, and it aggravates.
Yeah.
You know? Because then you get like... You almost feel bad for the guys.
Yeah.
Because they're just stupid.
Stupid and just brought along.
And the actual, the bad person gets away.
Yeah.
Because women never do anything bad.
Oh, no.
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 Obviously, it couldn't be her.
Yeah.
It's great. It's a great film.
Yeah.
And it's awkward and horrible.
Oh, yeah.
And there's so many moments, and it points out other people. It's like, okay, I'll go in there and watch and do this. As soon as it gets really creepy, I'm running.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then even that guy comes around and calls the cops.
Yeah.
You know? So it's
a good... And I think people appreciate that.
I don't think that... It really is a play on human nature. A lot of that film shows the weakness and faults and good things about this movie. And it doesn't really hold back. Like, when she falls, like, when she's all naked and just, like, falls out of the train.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's brutal.
Yeah.
Like, the knife to the...
Yeah, knife to the...
The John.
Yeah. Yeah, just very interesting films.
Yeah, really. It's gristly, but it's got weight.
And it's got meat to it, yeah.
See, speaking of Last House on the Left, I think that's a ridiculously flawed film.
Yeah.
I still find it just as entertaining as it did the first time. He doesn't like tattoo games.
It's too cold. Actually, he even with a nice knot, should be great.
See, my biggest problem, although it's one of the things I like most, is the detectives, the police, and Last House on the Left.
The people that are like really like inept.
Yeah. Just like, what? Chicken farmers? What?
I know. What's going on? What is going on? And we were talking about Last House at the Edge of the Park, which I think is a grossly underrated.
Yeah.
Most people have never even watched it.
Jared Lee Lowe's one, I think that's one of the weights of film.
Yeah.
Everyone thinks of Cannibal Holocaust.
Which I don't know, Cannibal Holocaust.
Right.
But he does play an amazing
asshole. Oh, yeah.
It's just like, you can't get better than Nick.
David Hess
is the best of the game.
Yeah.
But even that, you can say about The Last House of the Edge of the Park is it's a ridiculously overblown plot to get someone back.
Yeah.
And like at any point in time, the people that were trying to pull the job could have got killed. At any point in time.
They could have just been, it could have ended.
And it could have ended really, really quickly. Yeah. But I think the weirdest thing was David Hess. You can see in the film, he was just playing with the people. He really wasn't going to kill anybody.
Yeah.
And then it turned into this whole big deal because I'm just an idiot trying to get paid and fucking around.
It just turned like the upper class looking down.
Yeah.
Like the film of Giovanni, Lombardo, with Jesus
Christ. Yeah. And he was really good in City of the Living Dead.
Yeah. He could play these dumb, dumb people, like even Cannibal Ferox. He's like a dumb, arrogant, idiot gets his dick fucked up.
And then the other thing is, in City of the Living Dead, he's just an idiot that doesn't know any better and he gets killed again.
Yep, does nothing wrong.
Yeah, does nothing wrong and he gets drilled through his head.
Yeah. Like you say when we talk about, he's essentially murdered.
Yeah, there's a murderer in that film.
There's a murder with all this paranormal stuff, but that's the worst.
I think the best part of that film, which I know other people have explored without on CD covers and stuff, is when she throws up her gun.
Oh, yeah.
It just makes no absolute sense at all, but why does it need to?
Yeah, exactly.
And then I love the fact that she crushes the guy's head like he doesn't have a skull.
Yeah, there's just like little bits just squeezing out.
Yeah.
As if there's like tiny holes.
Yeah.
Like strong skulls.
No, a human head is only cling wrap
with hair on it.
Yeah. And you just squeeze it. And that's fine. There's no skull.
He's actually got a baby's head.
Yeah,
it's the fortunate man.
He's got a cantaloupe head.
Squish.
The spam of a beret.
I was thinking of getting a beret.
Do you think about getting a beret? You look at almost more than enough of the cock anyway.
Exactly, just go full.
Accentuate the cock.
Just go.
I'm the one dressed, I'm on the one with like a hat and a big duster in Manchester, it looks like a dick, so.
We were so very fucking odd to go walk down the street together.
Together, especially.
Yeah. See, this is okay because we're just in t-shirts, so we're like ready actually walking outside.
And you had a big scarf on.
Yeah.
And I had the thing.
Yeah. It's like these people should not be in the same size.
We even slept near each other. Hard all night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Their thoughts would be
brutal. Brutal.
Yeah. I he crop dusted somebody in Tesco's last.
Yes, he did.
Yes, I did. Pretty bad.
He usually takes a lot for me to find. Disgusting what that was.
That was fantastic. Nothing like crop dusting those people in Tesco's. Whoa.
Yeah, that was an interesting walk home, actually.
Yeah. We were cold.
Yeah. So he gave me. See, that was still a little fucking weird.
That was weird, too.
Yeah. The girly beer mug bag. Because that bag is very girly, yeah. That thatched bag.
I was carrying that.
Yeah. It's like a woman's bag.
Yeah. I was carrying all my box and my thatched beer mug bag, and I draped my jacket over Peter's shoulders because he was cold. And look, it was chilly, and I wasn't because I was drunk.
Yeah.
You know, so I wasn't cold.
Yeah, so you're still about 5 or 6 ahead of me.
Yeah, yeah. I had about 12 or 13 beers last night, and then we reviewed one, and then I crashed out on the couch, yeah. And I fell asleep, apparently.
Yeah, you just fell asleep. And then I started to fall asleep, so I fell for confidence, man.
Yeah, as soon as I did that, I woke up going, okay, let's drink some more, and I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, Peter's asleep, I guess I'm going to go to sleep too.
Yeah.
So we're basically been an old married couple that goes to sleep at like 7 p.m.
Exactly.
And wakes up at 4 in the morning.
Yep.
Well, who cares? Because I'm waking up feeling good.
Yeah.
We can come out here and proper fry up.
Exactly.
Yeah. And start drinking super early.
Yeah. So, we've got to hit up a couple of pubs today.
Yeah.
And as we saw that there were two J.W. Lee's lorries loaded up at the pub.
Mm-hmm.
The J.W. Lee's pub, so. Fresh J.W. Lee, sounds good to me.
Someone literally just opened the door. I think she might be locking it again. But she came out of the city. She's locking. I need her to unlock, not to lock.
And you need to lock it.
You need to open it. So, yeah, just check the handle. She's walking down.
Ooh, she's probably going to get a coffee or something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's terrible time. It's only like 8 in the morning, or 8:40 or 8:50 in the morning, so it's not even 9. Some of these pubs probably don't even open till 10.
Probably not.
Yeah.
There's got to be places that have got licensed.
Well, the Crown and Anchor is great, and actually, I don't know if you guys have seen it. You probably haven't seen the film, but we went to like Deansgate was a fantastically.
Oh, yeah, that was gorgeous.
The beer wasn't the greatest, but like the atmosphere was amazing.
Like each bill, like each room's just completely different.
Yeah, it looks completely
full of character, like,
and the antiquity of it.
Yeah,
it was amazing. You were just wondering, we were talking about the kind of like the. Taste the blood of Dracula.
Yeah,
with the higher ups doing
libertines and sallow.
Yeah, doing horrible things behind closed doors and places like that.
And it just felt like that.
It did. It really did.
Once you learn that.
Proper knocks, the wall opens up, and that's where all the hookers are doing things with animals and snakes.
That's why they put the red hooks.
Yeah. So like on this side of the building, they're having like a satanic ritual. On this side of the building, they're doing weird things with hookers and stuff. But then they go home and preach the gospel to their families and beat their wives if they talk back.
It's got that, but in a good way.
But in a good
way. We're not like criticizing the place. We actually.
No. That was
that's the appeal.
That's the appeal. It's so. That's the cool thing about it. I mean, and it did feel old. I mean, obviously it was, but it just like had that atmosphere.
Yeah.
And the antiquity of the place definitely
felt legitimate, not like, oh, we bought this chair, we aged it, we went.
Yeah.
Yeah. They actually felt like this is the 18th century.
Yeah.
Sit down.
Yeah. You had an abbot.
Yep, that's good.
It tasted exactly like cram grape juice into the water.
Yeah.
It wasn't bad. You could chug it. It was 5%, and it tasted exactly like the Bimbo cranberry juice and water.
Exactly.
Very odd. And I can't remember what else we had there, because we had like 3.
You had the Old Speckle Hen.
Oh, I had 2 Old Speckle Hens.
And I had a Honey Bechdel.
And you had a honey,
from the Cheshire Brewery or something.
Well, who doesn't love the tongue of the honey hole?
Exactly. Yeah, it was the honey hole.
Yeah.
It's actually called the honey hole.
Yep.
See, I wasn't that drunk.
And then we had a brisk walk in the night back, and we gave lots of money to random homeless women? Because they were all women. I didn't know this. We should just took them all back to our
home. Yeah, exactly. Well, come back, try to talk back to the Deansgate.
Deansgate, yeah. Exactly. Have a couple of pints.
Yeah, have a couple of pints and a couple of hours later.
Yeah,
which rolls begin?
Yeah.
So, you've got something to do tonight,
then? Yeah, tonight. I can pick you up.
Get the free bus.
Yeah, get the free bus.
We'll fill it with these...
A whole harem of homeless women into a bus and take them to a pub and get them shit faced.
That's your pub.
He's got a hand out.
Yeah.
There's gotta be something. There's gotta be some payoff. But yeah, that sounds fantastic. Right now we're just kind of chilling out at the coffee pot.
Yep.
Let our food sink in, sipping on some tea. Then we're gonna hit foggy, misty morning Manchester.
I'm gonna have a look at the beer shop. Just for about see if we find some ancient Jacob E. Lee's beers.
Yeah, we'll definitely have to check it out. And I have to get a pluggy thing so this phone doesn't die.
Yep.
That's about it right now.
So we've got a good show today.
Peter was telling me all about his films, no spoilers, that he's going to try to make one day.
Yep.
Yeah.
We're going to have to write the actual scripts too.
Yeah. But we can't tell you too much because Quentin Tarantino will steal this.
Yeah. Especially on these school cues.
Exactly. And he will ruin it too.
Yeah, he will.
Yep.
So. You defeated?
Yeah. Yeah, I went defeated.
No worries.
Thank you.
So, I guess. The plate is clean, the table's clean, and we're going to say goodbye.
Till
we'll see you at JW Lee's.